about a decade ago, I was in corporate America doing the traditional grind that that so many people like me were doing, and realizing that it was something I probably didn't want to do forever, but was likely going to have to do. And ended up meeting and playing golf with a gentleman who was selling this thing called a turnkey asset, or rental properties, that I really didn't understand. Ended up befriending him. And it just happens to be Marck de Lautour, owner of SBD Housing. But at that time, he started explaining to me the benefits of, you know, bringing on real estate as a passive investment to drive income later in life. And so initially bought my first asset from Marck.
So this is 10 years ago.
Yeah, this was about 10 years ago.
Exactly, 2011.
Yep.
You're an executive selling, what were you selling?
Medical diagnostics, yeah.
Okay, so you're selling medical diagnostics, doing well.
Yeah, life was good.
And you were living?
At that time in Kansas City.
So you were in Kansas City at this time. And this guy, Marck, is just hanging out at the country club.
It's a little worse than that, actually. So I go, I'm a new member. Yeah, he should have been. I'm a new member, and I was a decent player at the time. And the pro's like, oh, you're a decent player. You should go play with this gentleman. Mm-hmm. Sure, great. I'll play with anybody. So he convinces me that we just play a straight-up game. I don't know him from Adam. And he goes on to just beat the living snot out of me. Come to find out, at that time, he was like, you know, two-time club champ. He was on to become like 10-time club champ. So that's how I met Marck.
So he's pretty good at golf.
Well, and he's pretty good at not setting a bet.
Yeah.
So anyhow, I got to meet Marck, became friends, and really started buying turnkey real estate with the hope of building up a portfolio so that one day, if I ever tired of corporate America, I'd be in a position to say, you know what, this isn't for me anymore. I've got 30, 40 rentals that are producing X amount of cash flow. I'm not going to do that thing you're asking me to do. Mm-hmm. I'm out. So that was the plan.
So that's different than most people, because most people, you know, they're reading a book or, you know, they're miserable at their jobs, and they're like, something's got to give. That was not your situation.
Well, I like everybody else who's listened to this, certainly had read Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Mm-hmm. But I was raised, like so many Americans, to put my money in the stock market. My wife, myself, we had our 401ks. If we had a good year and we had some leftover money, it would go into Roth IRA. Maybe at that stage, you know, we were into traditional IRAs.
Yeah.
But that was what I had been learning. Even though I'd read that, you still get programmed. Mm-hmm. Certainly, if you're a corporate employee, max out your 401k. And I was a Dave Ramsey fan and Susie Orman. So I read it all.
You were a Dave Ramsey. Okay.
So we can talk about that, too. We can talk about Dave. Still a big fan. But but Marck really opened my eyes to what that could do for me. And what was most amazing, you know, if you read any of the literature, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, you're reading a book, whatever. How, the question isn't, is it a good idea, Steve? It's, how can I do it? Mm-hmm. I was not going to be able to find a distressed asset. You certainly didn't want me rehabbing it. I didn't know what property management was. Certainly couldn't pick out a good rental rate. So it wasn't that I didn't believe in real estate. It just wasn't easy and available for me to invest in. Yeah. And that's really what SBD Housing, Marck de Lautour, was able to change for me at that time, was to bring something that was really hands-off and something I could implement pretty easily.
So is that similar to your clientele today when you sell in turnkey? Is people, executives or people that are higher net worth individuals that know real estate is the key but don't have the bandwidth or resources to do that?
Absolutely. Yeah, it is. It is individuals that see the value in real estate, not just turnkey, but real estate in general, Steve. Maybe are either not in love with the stock market or maybe have some money in the stock market, but are looking to diversify and see real estate as that key. But again, they're busy, they're professionals, or they recognize, I don't want to do that. I'd be bad at that. And we provide that solution. So really in the end, SBD these days is providing investment opportunities backed by real estate for high net worth individuals who are looking to expand their portfolio and ideally use real estate as a way to ensure their legacy.
And how many properties did you buy from Marck?
I bought seven.
So you bought seven properties from Marck.
Yep.
And then over a span of how much time?
Gosh, it kind of dripped in and out over the years. So probably over 6 or 7 years. Yep.
Okay. So what was it that prompted the conversation that you guys should link up?
Boy. So I looked, you know, it's interesting, Steve. When I was in corporate, again, happy to have been there, learned a tremendous number of things, was able to do a lot of good things for my family. But early on, I realized that I didn't enjoy it. I was, it just wasn't who I was, who I wanted to be. And it was just taking a big toll on me. And I knew if I was successful, I'd get the opportunity to be promoted again and take on more responsibility. And then if I did that really well, I could do that again with more people that I didn't like mm-hmm. or trust. And I had just a clear vision. I looked at the players that were, you know, at the SVP level, they were exhausted. They were 55. They were overweight, had a heart attack, divorced, etc. I mean, that's just, you know, I'm a little generality here, but that's the truth.
I mean, honestly, when I was working at Intel, that's kind of what I was looking at. You know, I was like, okay, so everyone that's like the future path,
the success
of success is I get promoted to management. None of the managers are happy.
Correct.
They're all working 50, 60 hours. They're expected to work on weekends and reply to emails at night. There was not a road. There was not a lane for me to fill working in the corporate world.
Just grind it out, man. Just do it more.
Just do more of it.
Yeah.
You make more money, but you're not enjoying life.
Correct. And so I was just at that stage where I knew there had to be a better way. I didn't know what it was. And, you know, through conversation with Marck, recognizing that if I could build up cash flow, which clearly the stock market is build up and deplete method, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if I could build up some cash flow by using rentals, ideally I'd be at that stage, whatever it was. I was going to grind it out, but clearly I haven't because I'm here today. And have 30 assets kicking off a couple hundred, $300,000 a year, whatever that looked like. So one day I could say, no, that's not for me anymore. Mm-hmm. That was going to be like in my mid-50s.
But something changed.
Something did change.
What changed?
Boy, a lot changed. So, for Marck, something changed, which brought a great opportunity for me, Steve.
Got it.
So, I know Mark's been on the podcast and shared the story with you. So I'll give you, kind of the high level. But, you know, when he was building the business, the main acquisition channel was really buying on the courthouse steps through the auction process. And as auction.com and some other things in the market changed and evolved, it became so competitive that margin was just getting depleted and depleted and depleted. And Mark's, he's a visionary, he's an expert in this space, saw that coming and thought, I need to find a better way. And I was a sales guy, building sales teams for a long time. He said, hey, I need to do this seller direct thing. I need to start buying assets. Not raise my hand, you could help me with that. So I started doing some consulting for Marck, helping him look at what a sales
using your corporate like. Background.
Using my corporate background on my limited nights and weekends in exchange for discounts on real estate. and that was going to be fine. I was going to help him in that way. But then I had an opportunity to go with him down to Collective Genius just to check it out. He kept talking about this Collective Genius, CG, this, that. But I was like, you want to go? And I'm like, sure, let me go see what your investor buddies do. Blew my mind. Clearly, smartest, greatest people, organized, helping each other, go-givers. And it just was so different. So anyhow, I see that Marck's in a position where the weight of the world's on his shoulders as a solopreneur. He's tired. He's not having fun anymore. And we went to dinner that night, and he was just whooped. And he's like, hey, I'm going to go down to my house, down the coast. You're going to head out. So Marck left. I got on the airplane the next day. I was so excited about what I saw and knew what real estate could do for people and knew what I could do for Marck. It was crystal clear, right? I saw what CG can do and I saw what I was good at. So I took out my iPad, and not many people know the story, and I started typing all the reasons that Marck needed to hire me. And I just kept going and going.
Bring a sales presentation.
Essentially.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was. And I mean, he's a dear friend of mine. Sarah Beth's a dear, our families are close. And I wanted to help him. So ironically, I get off the airplane. I get a text message that says, hey, can you talk in the morning? Whatever time's good for you. Sure. Marck calls me the next morning. Is like, hey, I've had a chance to reflect. I've talked to my wife. I've talked to my dad. I really think you should come work for me. And, I buried the lead here. I gave him the out, and I was like, I agree with you. He's like, well, think about it. I said, Marck, I can send you an email right now, the top 10 reasons you need to hire me. So we're pretty much in alignment on this thing. So call it what you want, happenstance, God thing is what Marck and I refer to it. It was meant to be.
Didn't play any hard to get at all. I don't know.
He would argue some of those things I did. We might have had a disagreement on my value. initially, I think we're fine with it now. No, I mean, man, I was tired and I was ready to make a change too.
Yeah.